The way we have structured this workshop is to explore the ideas, the kind of work that is happening in the industry. And here I have like the panel which comprises of the some of the practitioners. These are the emerging and growing retailers coming with brilliant ideas. And we also have emerging retail solution providers who are also coming with ideas and offerings which are trying to address the unaddressed market. Okay. So to start with, may I request each one of you to introduce yourself and tell us briefly about what your business is and maybe some background of your business so that everyone benefits from that. Okay. Maybe we'll start with Hiren. Hindi mein baat kar sakte. ठीक है, so Harish Chaudhary he runs a supermarket in Thane, a 4,000 square feet supermarket called Dwarkesh supermarket, and in his catchment area they are like really a force to reckon with. They in their neighborhood they have a DMart and they understand how to survive and grow despite DMart being around. Okay, so that is Harish.
Hi, good morning all. I'm Sunil Pathak. I work for P.N. Gadgil & Sons. It's a jewelry retail. We had our almost 13-14 branches across Maharashtra, and now we are considering ourselves as a growing retailer. So though we have 13-14 branches, but we don't have that much corporate setup, and with the use of this technology, we are trying to serve for the society and customer at our best.
Okay, the P.N. Gadgil as a brand, they are almost 100 year old. Okay.
It's almost 175 years old.
175 year old. So that is the history that they bring to the table here. Okay, Ayyappan, please.
Hi, good morning, everybody. I am Ayyappan Swami. I am heading the marketing and franchisee operation for Mongini's Foods. Mongini's, as you know, is again a 100 year old heritage brand, and we had a virtual monopoly for many decades, but now the competition is catching up, and you know we are also trying to reinvent and reposition ourselves. Yeah, thanks.
Okay. Rupal.
Hello, this is Rupal Agarwal representing Mulchand Sarees, which is again a 70-year-old brand into sarees from Pune. We have three stores in the heart of the city, coming up with a fourth store in process, and we are also in the process of reinventing and framing our SOPs, our processes and policies. Since last 1 year, we're working on that.
Great.
Thanks.
Good morning, friends. I'm Bala. I am co-founder and CEO of WhatsApp On Demand. We are a young laundry and dry cleaning convenience brand. As we have started during the evolution of retail, we are omnichannel, so we are there in physical retail as well as the mobile app world. We are currently at three cities, Chennai, Bangalore, and Delhi. We are growing to about 10 cities in the next 12 months.
I am Mayank Mohan. I own a brand called Mohanlal Sons. We are an independent retailer based out of New Delhi. We are a 130-year-old brand, but he beat me to it now. He's even older. But we are a family-run business. We only started thinking about expanding in the last 5 years. Our flagship showroom has been in Connaught Place, and now we are looking to add two more stores by the end of the year.
Sure.
Hi, very good morning. I'm Nimal Acharya, founder and CEO of Control Post. I put in around 30 years in the retail IT industry, gone to a long phase of industry where technology has been always been a key play. That is where I've moved and formed this company to provide a technology-driven company where the retailers and the people would benefit in, and also to retain their customers. What are the ways where you can retain your customer, how the way you can give your service to the customers, and move the technology from not only to tier one, but tier two and tier three cities, where I foresee a very big change in coming years to come in.
Okay. Yeah, hi, my name is Sagar Zaukhedkar. I am the founder and director of Ariatech Mobility Solutions. We primarily work on the retail sector, and we have we provide solutions and offerings in the retail sector, right from POS solutions to the new app.
Speak in the mic.
Okay. To the new app that we're working on called 360 Degrees, which will target the retail sector completely. So that's where we are right now. Okay.
Sure, great. So if you notice, we have a really a mix of the segments being represented over here. We have grocery, we have jewelry, we have treats or the bakery kind of a thing. We are talking about sarees, we are talking about the garments, and we have also laundry services. Okay. And we have two service providers who are, so Nigam is trying to basically provide a point of sale solutions kind of a thing, whereas Sagar is trying to offer hyper local kind of a solutions. Okay. Now, so the question is like to the retailers over here, what I would like to understand, okay, over last 2 years, 3 years, okay, how's the business? Is business growing, the kind of opportunities you are seeing, okay, and what is forcing you to, like some of you talked about, like heritage brands especially, that now we are thinking of doing something different, something bigger than what we are doing in the past, okay. So what is prompting you to do so?
Yeah.
Shall I? Please.
Yeah. Though I mentioned I had a brand of with 175 years, but in the recent 10 years, we developed ourselves into from 2 store to 13 stores. So as far as concerned to jewelry retail, it's growing. It's almost growing. But the other brands and other chota sarafas are not doing that much well because of that Gold Control Act, some taxes and levies, all that. But as far as concerned with PN Gadgil, we are doing marvelous in the last 2-3 years. And every year we are setting targets and we are completing our performance beyond the targets. But the problem is we had a large number of footfalls. But the data analytics and all that are the issues with this technology. So we are still unable to doing that data analysis and other parts.
Sure.
Yeah. Coming to our company, Mongenies, basically we had a virtual run, you know, Monopoly, and it was synonymous with the cakes. You know, Mongenies and cakes go together. But what has happened in the last 10 years, India as a society has become more aspirational, you know. Even at a lower strata, people aspire to come into express their individuality. And what better way to, you know, express their individuality than cake? You know, it's being aspirational, has a premium positioning, but still it is affordable. Unlike, you know, a car, if you want to have a Skoda car, you know, you can't afford, but he'll go for a Tata Nano. But here in cake, you can go for a premium product, but within the affordable range. So Mongenies was always value for money. So we thought ki, rather than having this value for money, that's a core value which we can't compromise on. But we also need to cater to this aspirational society that is coming into the system, the youngsters. So over the last 3-4 years, we have come out with a premium product range, and the masses have really appreciated, and actually the masses have adopted the premium. So in spite of being a mass market brand, the premiums are still being accepted by the consumers.
Rupal.
So the growth is always there. In the last 3 years, of course, the growth is there. But like some mentioned rightly, the mentality of the Indian masses is changing, and now they are becoming more and more brand conscious. So even the regional retailers need to build a brand and need to spread out their wings across the state for them to sustain and to compete with the foreign brands that are coming.
Okay, but in a brand like a category like sarees, do you see really a outside
brands
competition?
Brands are being built up, definitely, definitely. Okay. You have something like Jashan, which is like spreading like wildfire.
Sure.
There are a lot of brands from south that are emerging, and
okay, so there is a kind of a territorial war that is
going on. So either you build a brand, because the regional retailers will automatically, having one or two stores will slowly collapse. You either build a brand, become big.
Okay.
So your sustainability will increase, and probably your entire your purchase cycle and everything, then you are more at an advantage. If you have more number of stores, you get a lot of advantage everywhere, right from the purchase to the sales.
Okay. Sure. So when you are saying there is the opportunity, you are saying the customers are changing, mentality is changing, they're becoming more brand conscious. They are willing to accept the premiumization of the products and services. Okay, maybe Bala, you can talk about like in an unorganized sector like a laundry. Okay, why you think like a laundry as a retail format and as a chain format? What kind of opportunity you see which others maybe fail to see?
Yeah, so we are in an interesting sector, which is service sector. So in terms of, we are shifting, as you rightly said, the unorganized sector to organized. The estimate is that the laundry business itself in the top 20 cities in India is about 2 lakh crore. And we have about 11 million dhobis in India, which are not growing, which are actually cutting down. Because people, they are educating their kids and they are moving out of the profession. Nobody is continuing the next generation in laundry. So what's happening is the shift is, the consumer shift is moving from unorganized to organized. And we are at that stage, probably what the barber industry was about 10 years before. You had barbers every nook and corner, but now you see only stylists. And the same barber you paid 20 bucks, you're paying 200 bucks to the stylist now. So that's what eventually will happen in laundry. So I come from a background from fashion retail in products. Now I'm in services. I see a lot of difference in consumer behavior because this is an essential product, right? And the competition is less. Organized competition is less. But unfortunately, we are competing with an unorganized competition. But we need to, again, up the product delivery, service, you know, enable technology like, you know, mobile app. Dhobi can never do a mobile app. But on the other side, what we are trying to do is we are seeing how we can co-opt Dhobi into the system. So our motto is that we want to elevate the Dhobi rather than eliminate. So we have a lot of people who have come in onto our platform, and we'll also be soon launching an app which will connect to the Dhobi. So that's where we feel we are in a slightly different sector.
Sure. So you are believing that the technology can actually help you in making this entire segment organized, yeah. Right? Yeah. And tap the maybe a latent demand. Okay. Yeah. So again, going back to all of you, how you see, like you explain the kind of a challenge or an opportunity you see. Okay. But especially what kind of a technology do you normally look at? Okay. When we talk to the big retailers, they talk about supply chain, they talk about merchandising management. I don't know whether this kind of a things are applicable to you or what kind of where you start and what you look at while investing into the technology.
One example that I can right away share with all of you is that Bombay being a very congested city, you know, like, you know, we are expanding in north also and other places also, but parking is a big problem, and we have got close to 270 cake shops in Bombay. So whenever the van goes for the delivery in the morning, the van has to park outside the cake shop, and if there is a very narrow or a congested lane, so the traffic police guy comes in, the society creates a ruckus, and a lot of issues are there. So here we have taken help of the technology, where we have developed an in-house proprietary technology, where before the van moves out, each of the shop's orders, what and all products they have ordered, it is all captured in a high definition image, and directly uploaded to a link which has a user ID and password given to the cake shop. So even before the van reaches, he'll come to know today what is the goods he's going to get, the count he can take. He can check for the design. If there is any problem with the design, he can immediately escalate. If the design is okay, then everything is fine. The van comes in, unloads the good. Within 5 minutes, it goes. In a normal course of time, it would have taken 20, 25 minutes. But here, within 5 minutes. So this is where we are using technology to solve our day-to-day problems. So one of the examples that I can share with all of the groups.
Rupal, you have any where your like investments? What point you have started?
Initially, we started with the problems of stocks as usual. So stock management was what we are looking at, but now over a period of time, we are looking more at the CRM solutions. Stock is now resolved and pretty much organized. Mm-hmm. We are more looking at the CRM solution.
Please.
So you know, before we move on to technology, I wanted to ask, especially people who are traditional retailers, I can see four of you here. I want to understand what is the attitudinal shift and mind shift you have taken to compete in the modern retail space? Because you've been a traditional retailer, so your business was run with traditional practices, traditional attitude, and a lot of customers were taken for granted, right? Now, what has prompted you attitudinally to become and, you know, come and stand next to the modern retailers? I think that before we get into technology space, what is the thinking process which has gone in your business, which has made you, you know, think like a modern retailer?
Yeah. Why modern retailer? I think that's the question.
Yeah.
You can continue. You don't have to bend your neck.
Sure. As I told in my opening address that India as a society has become very aspirational. So every product or every service or every commodity is getting branded. So in my cake, since I am a cake retailer, I'll talk about my cake category. In cake itself, it is again getting into different segment. It is getting fragmented. One category is of self-consumption. You have a Black Forest cake, you eat for your own self. Then people are expressing their own individuality by having this designer cake. We are calling it 3D cake. This is a big craze in the market. So today I am a musician or today I am a painter. I want a cake made up with a guitar and drums and things like that. So people are expressing their individuality through this cake. So if we want to reinvent ourselves and be relevant to this modern consumer, we have to position ourselves to cater this needs. And if we don't do it, then we become a fuddy-duddy brand. So that's the challenge, and that's the reason why we are trying to reinvent ourselves or reposition ourselves.
If I can also just chime
please,
in.
Please.
Mohanlal Sons, we were MBO, multi-brand outlet, for the first 100-odd years of our life. But we soon, and we were the highest seller of Madura garments in North India. But we realized somewhere in the late 90s, early 2000s, that we will not be able to compete with the Shopper Stops in lifestyle of the world. So we used our brand's goodwill and we totally changed our business.
What made you feel that you were not able to compete? Did you start losing customers to Shopper Stop?
We did. Okay. Because, if the same brands that we can, because we have, our flagship showroom is about 3,000 square feet. Shopper Stop or lifestyle would be in 30,000 square feet. So number of brands they can carry and the space they can provide to those brands, there was no way we could have ever matched that. So we basically went into ceremonial wear. So what she is doing, we're doing it on the men's side of things. So we specialized into Sherwanis, we specialized into Jodhpuris. We started doing that, and fabrics and tailoring was always a forte. So that is something that we built on. And now we've completely changed our business model. We've turned into a boutique. I totally agree with you. We're trying to become a brand. On our side of things, the only national brand is Manyavar. And right. We are catering to a slightly different segment than we are. Mm-hmm. But still, there's a lot of scope for other brands to come in. So that's why now we're trying to grow, but we haven't, since a family-owned business, we are still circumspect about getting outside capital. So it's our own capital, so the pace of growth is slow. But we are looking to grow, and in fact, we are also targeting tier two towns more. So we opened in Chandigarh last year, we had a very good response. We're opening in Jammu next month. So we are looking at tier two towns, and we believe that tier two towns would end up giving us a much better growth than even towns like Delhi and Bombay.
But Mayank, just building on what you are saying, is it like a generational shift, like in the family now, for example, people like you who are young, educated, exposed to the world, okay, and may have worked maybe outside the family, okay, and is that influencing your decisions to like transform your business?
Absolutely, because when I joined the business about 7 years back, basically run as the mom and pop store.
Yeah.
We used to have one store in Connaught Place, and the purana jo hota tha galle pe baith jao. So that was the mindset, which is very good if you want to run one store. But that model cannot be sustainable.
That is the point I wanted to understand, because normally the system in the traditional businesses was that the expansion was limited to the family members available to manage the business. Today, when you are talking of getting into smaller towns, what is making you think like that? Because you may not have enough family members to manage every business or every business location, even in smaller towns.
So that's what we're looking to do now.
So
we're trying.
What has brought that shift in your mind that you are willing to open a shop in, let's say, in Amritsar or in Chandigarh, where somebody professionally running that, and what has you given up mentally which allows you to do that?
Mentally, basically, what you have given is control. So you have to somehow, the earlier mentality was, jitne, for example, the number of brothers are there, right?
Yeah.
So you'll open those many stores, someone would sit in each store. But then you have to become more professional. So we are hiring more professional people. We're hiring, we recently hired someone who would eventually be a regional manager, which we never had. So we are hiring, trying to make it more professional. Technology has helped. CCTV cameras have helped. Centralized, system, inventory system, centralized sales systems have helped. Otherwise, it would have been impossible to grow. So that is the kind of mindset that has changed, and I used to actually work for Deloitte Consulting for several years before I joined.
Sure, I could figure that.
Some of that experience also hopefully would help out.
I would like to add one point.
Please.
Also. In my company, there was an ownership, there was a small partnership firm.
Yeah.
And I joined company almost 16 years back as a salesman, and now I'm working as a HR head of the company. So the shift from ownership to other person, so our owners is increasing their family members. राइट जस्ट लाइक मेंशन कि वो चार पांच भाई रहते थे उन्हीं में वो दुकान ये हो जाता था बट नाउ नाउ डेज जस्ट बाला सेड राइटली कि वी आर ट्राइंग टू से आवरसेल्फ एज अ वी आर इन सर्विस इंडस्ट्री मोर देन द रिटेल इंडस्ट्री फॉर सर्विस इंडस्ट्री यू नीड टू ग्रो यू नीड टू हैव गुड सेटअप एंड गुड टेक्नोलॉजी यूज टू सस्टेन एंड रिटेन इन बिजनेस
Just to add one point, you know, all this traditional family business, on a very positive, you know, optimistic note, you know, if you see Walmart, for its 50 years of its existence, it was available only in one state in America.
Yep.
Only after 50 years, they started expanding in other 50 states. So, you know, even if you are late, so there is, that's
Never
not an
late.
Issue. That's not,
Okay. So, let's go back to now the technology.